Good morning to you. Thanks very much for joining us. Devin Nunes, I want to kick it off with you because your colleague over in the Intel committee, Adam Schiff, is telling the press that this is all Russian disinformation. And you say?
Well, I would just say go back for the last 4 years. This is the genius that said he had more than circumstantial evidence that the Trump campaign was colluding with Russia. What we now know is we now have evidence it was actually the Democrats, the Democratic National Committee, and the Clinton campaign that were colluding with Russia. And in fact, there are some similarities here, Maria. If you remember, we had the whole media in D.C. was all over Europe looking for Moscow prostitutes, money that was supposedly moving from Moscow or Ukraine into the Trump campaign or the Trump orbit. We looked for that for the last 4 years. It ends up that that story that ended up in the Clinton dossier that they fed into the FBI was true, except it was a fantasy based off of the Biden family. So there are prostitutes, there is Moscow money. I don't know if there's P tapes or not, but it involves the Bidens, and they have a whole lot of explaining to do before the American people go to vote in this next election.
I know that they accused you, Devin Nunes, you were on my program multiple times when they were accusing you of going to Ukraine. Remember, they had accused you of going to Ukraine to try to get dirt on Joe Biden. In fact, there really was dirt on Joe Biden. You were not in Ukraine, and we established that back then. But you can say today that these emails are legitimate. Go ahead.
Well, I should say that fake news CNN and the rest of the screwballs in the media have never apologized. They've never taken down that story. That story's still out there that I went to Vienna to meet with all these nefarious Ukrainians. And I think the point here, Maria, is that I should have known then, after being through this for 4 years, I should have got on a plane immediately and went to Vienna and went to Ukraine, because it ends up all those people had a whole bunch of dirt on Biden. And how do we know that?
Right.
We have Treasury records, we have financial records, and now we have multiple emails that are all smoking guns.
Congressman McCarthy, you are the leader of this party. You are facing pushback, not just from the FBI withholding information, but the media as well. What are you going to do about it?
Well, first of all, what Devin says is correct. What did we learn now? It's a very similar playbook. We are just now finding out 4 years later that the CIA did know that Hillary Clinton was making up the Russian idea with President Trump, that Brennan actually briefed President Obama, that they sent a memo to the FBI, to Comey and Peter Strzok, and never told anybody in Congress or the American public. Now we find right before the eve of an election that Hunter Biden, Joe Biden, money could be involved here, all the speculations of things we've heard before. And Maria, it comes down to one simple question. The American public deserves the right to know, and Joe Biden has a responsibility to answer these questions, which he's avoiding. Before this election takes place, these questions need to be answered before the American public. Because is the FBI, did they have this computer? Did they know of this again? Are they repeating the same bad behaviors before? And it is out in the public right now that China is trying to influence our election. That's what the FBI tells us. The most sophisticated country, the one that has the one of the largest economies coming after us, and they have a directive of what they want to do. They want to assist Joe Biden. Exactly what big tech is doing as well.
Well, I want to get into this further. We're going to take a short break, but I've got to ask you about big tech and what will be the fate of Twitter and Facebook blocking the New York Post story about Hunter Biden. Stay with us, Kevin McCarthy and Devin Nunes. We'll be right back.
Ready, set, go. Live big in the three larger-than-life SUVs from GMC. Step up to GMC and get $5,500 purchase allowance on most 2020 Acadia models. We are professional grade. GMC.
Have you wanted to speak a new language but thought it would be too difficult? Then try Babbel. Babbel starts by teaching you words and phrases that gradually get more complex. Soon, you're practicing short conversations. So in 15 minutes a day, you'll be speaking a new language in a few weeks. Babbel works because it's built around real life. It teaches you everyday practical conversations that you will actually use. Babbel, language for life. Try it free at babbel.com.
Helping families with mesothelioma is all we do. My firm has been offering a free book on mesothelioma for over 10 years. Since that time, hundreds of people with mesothelioma have trusted us to represent them. We have local offices throughout the U.S. and there is no risk to you. Mesothelioma really is all we do. Call us at 1-800-333-4485. That's 1-800-333-4485. Or go to mesobook.com.
A live bookkeeper is helping customize QuickBooks for me.
Okay, you're all set up.
Thanks. That was my business key. This one's casual.
Get set up right with a live bookkeeper with Intuit QuickBooks.
If you suffer from muscle cramps in your legs and feet, TheraWorks Relief can help. With daily application, this fast-acting foam is clinically proven to prevent muscle cramps before they start.
Get TheraWorks Relief today. Available in stores everywhere.
The Biden controversy.
So why is this important? I'm about to show you why.
Mark Levin and Rudy Giuliani break it all down. Tonight on Life, Liberty, and Levin.
Which ones you want for Casey?
Esta?
Ready to go.
Introducing Walmart Plus, a new membership with mobile scan and go. Just scan, pay, and be on your way.
Sometimes the joy's in getting the recipe just right. Sometimes it's in getting it all over the kitchen.
Hey, Malcolm, your podcast on Audible, right?
That's right. And your new audiobook.
With everything from Mel Robbins to Blake Griffin, sleep stories, meditation. Is there a more fascinating place than Audible?
No. I've done the research.
You've done the research. Of course you have.
No, there's so much plaque.
Oh. Yes.
Looks like there's no plaque.
I'm definitely going to switch to Arm & Hammer.
Welcome back. We are back with House GOP leader Kevin McCarthy and Congressman Devin Nunes, the ranking member on the House Intelligence Committee. He is also the author of the new book, Countdown to Socialism. And I know, Devin Nunes, you've talked about social media in this book. But Congressman McCarthy, I want to start with you on this in this block, because you have been talking about social media, censoring information, shutting down GOP accounts for a long time. Now we're looking at the potential for new legislation. Talk to me where that stands, because Twitter and Facebook CEOs have been subpoenaed in the Senate because they tried to hide this Hunter Biden story.
Well, big tech should be ashamed of how they're so clearly trying to aid the Joe Biden campaign. And this is correct, Maria. This is something we've worked at for a long time. Just so your viewers understand, the American public desires free speech. So the federal government created a liability protection for tech companies to have a platform like Facebook and Twitter for liability protection where they cannot be sued. So they just let information out. People are able to say what they want. But now we're watching that big tech is using this and censoring individuals. Even they're censoring the federal government, they're censoring newspapers, they're censoring Americans based upon what they believe. They want to influence you for what you can think and what you can say. So it is time now that we scrap Section 230 and we start over. And in the Republican Judiciary Committee, we have a great bill to start out with. Jim Jordan as the ranking member, a number of members have already co-sponsored. That is where we should start, because as you remember, Maria, when I was majority leader, we brought in big tech. They would tell us one thing, but we have found they've continued to do another. Just as China's trying to influence our election, we now find that Twitter and Facebook are doing the exact same thing, and they should be ashamed. And the American public is outraged about this.
Real quick, when would you expect that legislation to happen? I mean, do you think this is a 2021 affair, that they lose that liability protection?
Well, if your viewers go out and vote, and they move forward like on our commitment to America, and we become the majority with just 17 seats to do that, I could promise you you'll see this legislation in January. But just as Nancy Pelosi has held any COVID relief for the American public, she has held up any legislation that will hold big tech accountable.
Devin Nunes, you have been an actual target of this. They have been on you for 4 years because you were exposing the corruption at the top of the FBI with that narrative of Donald Trump colluding. Tell us about that. And really, the FBI, why was it sitting on this information while there was a Senate trial attempting to impeach President Trump in January of this year?
Well, I think that's the big issue here. The folks that came forward, and my investigative team has actually been looking at this also, and I want to commend Senator Johnson and Senator Grassley because they've been drugged through the mud for the last year looking into this by the mainstream media while the media has ignored it. We have to go back to 2015. It was the Clinton campaign and the mainstream media who originally talked about all of this Burisma information and all of this corruption in Ukraine. Then you fast forward in the time when after the Mueller hoax completely implodes, Mueller embarrasses himself on TV after $40 million. They can't find any Trump with P tapes and Moscow prostitutes or any money going to the Trump campaign. That all dies. Then right at the time when the Ukraine hoax starts happening, when Trump is on the phone saying, hey, we hear you have a corruption problem, then this gentleman comes forward from Delaware and says, hey, I think I have evidence that is relevant to this investigation. How important would it have been for us that were investigating this and going through these bogus impeachment hearings for us to know that, in fact, there were emails that had Hunter Biden not only tied to Ukrainian companies, but to Moscow oligarchs and to the leader's point. I think the China problem is even worse. It looks like there's millions of dollars involved with China and the Bidens. This was all relevant information that the FBI was given that information specifically because of the impeachment of Trump, the way that our investigators understand it. So why would the FBI not get that immediately to the Congress? I think that's a question that they have to answer. And the faster they answer it, the better. If I were these agents that were involved in this, I'd separate myself from the DC swamp creatures. I don't know what that chain of command and where that information went up the chain of command, but the American people deserve a right to know it, and those agents should come forward and tell us who they gave this information to back in 2019 during the heat of the impeachment.
We've got to take a quick break, but I have one more question for you both. I mean, if there was a $3.5 million payout from the former wife of the former mayor of Moscow to a Trump sibling, there would be massive problems. You haven't heard a word about it. Let's take a short break and come back with Kevin McCarthy and Devin Nunes. Stay with us, gentlemen.
When I wake up in the morning, love, and the sunlight hurts my eyes, then I look at
good morning,
and I know it's gonna be a lovely.
This is the feeling of total protection. Now that we protect your identity and mobile phone as well as your auto, home, and life, you've never been in better hands. Allstate, click or call for a quote today.
For a close shave, you need to get a razor and lather up. For a quick shave on the go, you need to settle for an electric. But what if you really want both?
Nick Bolton here with the newest addition to our tactical line, the Bell & Howell Tac Shaver. Designed with the needs of our military in mind, Tac Shaver gives you a quick, razor-smooth shave whether you're at home or on the go. It even has a built-in trimmer for sideburns and beards. And it works wet or dry for a great shave in even the harshest conditions. That's right, the Tac Shaver is completely waterproof. In fact, you could even use a Tac Shaver underwater and still get a great shave. Navy guys, Tac Shaver is small and compact, so it slips easily into any pocket. Yet it also has three powerful rotary heads that can easily take on even the coarsest hair. To prove it, I'm gonna do something I never do. Shave. As you can see, it easily handled even my stubborn stubble. Now that's what I call military tough. So let's review. Tac Shaver gives you a quick, razor smooth shave, features a built-in trimmer, works wet or dry, even underwater, and has three powerful shaving heads.
I mean, there's just nothing like it on the market today.
Act now to get your tax shaver for this special TV price of just $29.99 with free shipping. It's the only shaver that features genuine Bell & Howell precision and quality and is backed by our 10-year warranty. That's right. Call or click today to get your tax shaver and we'll ship it to you free. Act now to get the Bell & Howell tax shaver at this special TV price. Here's how to order.
To order, call 1-800-957-2219 or go to taxshaver.com. That's 1-800-957-2219. Or you can order online at taxshaver.com.
Needles, essential for sewing, but maybe not for people with certain inflammatory conditions, because there are options, like an injection, Xeljanz. The first and only pill of its kind that treats moderate to severe rheumatoid arthritis, psoriatic arthritis, or moderate to severe ulcerative colitis, when other medicines have not helped enough. Xeljanz can lower your ability to fight infections. Before and during treatment, your doctor should check for infections like TB and do blood tests. Tell your doctor if you've had hepatitis B or C, have flu-like symptoms, or are prone to infections, serious, sometimes fatal infections, cancers, including lymphoma, and blood clots have happened. Taking a higher than recommended dose of Xeljanz for RA may increase risk of death. Tears in the stomach or intestines and serious allergic reactions have happened. Needles. Fine for some, but for you, there's a pill that may provide symptom relief. Ask your doctor about the pill first prescribed for RA more than 7 years ago. Xeljanz, an injection.
Welcome back. We are back with Congressman Kevin McCarthy and Congressman Devin Nunes. And Congressman Nunes, I want you to tell us what you believe is still out there that may very well come out this week. We mentioned earlier with Senator Johnson that the FBI agent who served the subpoena was actually looking at child pornography. And I also mentioned this $3.5 million payout to Hunter Biden from the former mayor of Moscow. That seems to have gone away. You've got social media just suppressing this news.
Yeah. The way I look at this, Maria, if the shoe was on the other foot, so for example, if Ivanka Trump had got a $3.5 million payment from a Russian oligarch, there would be a massive investigation. If there turned up Donald Trump's laptop with all sorts of emails tying that money to a pay-for-play scheme, essentially what we've been investigating the Trump campaign for and President Trump for the last 4 years, The question right now by the fake news media and the social media companies would be this. It would be, when is Trump resigning? If not, is he going to be impeached before the election? And when is Pence taking over? And in fact, that would happen for any governor, any U.S. congressman, any senator. In fact, Maria, I know your family had a pizza business. If your family's pizza business got a $3.5 million transaction, I guarantee you, you would be investigated because they would say, well, how on earth did, you know, Maria Bartiromo send $3.5 million of pizzas to Moscow? Right. That's what would happen to right. every American except for Joe Biden.
I understand. Congressman McCarthy, final word from you. What is this all going to mean for the election? Do you think this is resonating on the American voter out there? I mean, you see somebody like a Kim Klasick in Baltimore having been successful raising some $6 million. She's out raising her component. Does she have a shot? How are you feeling about the upcoming race, Congressman?
Well, I feel good. And it just shows that we're competitive no matter where the district. Kim is a fabulous candidate. This is a very Democratic district. But, Maria, you have to understand, we have twice as many women running as Republican in this cycle than we did last year, 95 than 2 years ago. You look at Nicole Malliotakis in New York, or you look at Stephanie Bice in Oklahoma City, Nancy Mace in Charleston, South Carolina, young Kim, Michelle Steele out in California. The real question that all the voters are asking in all these districts is, how much is it going to cost us if Joe Biden wins the election and the Democrats keep Congress? Because they know their taxes are going to go up on the very first day. We don't know if they're going to pack the court. We know they're going to try to change election law. We know they're going to make life harder that we're ever going to be able to get out of this. But on the Republican side, they have a commitment to America, that they have a cure for COVID, that they can rebuild our economy with 10 million new jobs, and they'll keep our streets safe. And that's the real question. How much will Joe Biden cost you personally? And that's the answer we need to know on Election Day. And so we're looking forward to it with 95 Republican women running across this country with an opportunity that tomorrow will be better than today.
Well, we will see if the media suppresses all of that. Kevin McCarthy and Devin Nunes, it's good to see you this morning, gentlemen.